You, I wanted to hate the Toyota Highlander. After all, I got into this business because I love cars that are the products of passion and extremes. And the Highlander cool DNT be more mommy if it were 9 months pregnant. The thing is, though, after a week with the Highlander, I cool DNT hate it. To the contrary, I had to respect it. The respect comes from the fact that Toyota managed to combine a bit of style and flair with oodles of practicality. The result is one of the best efforts I have seen at the always difficult compromise between the deep uncool of minivans and the glaring inefficiency of SUVs. And at only around $40. Oh, I can almost call it a bargain. Toyota's battle to make the Highlander compelling started on the outside. Previous generations of Highlander were never ugly. But they also could have been dishwashers for all their designers seemed to care. The new Highlander may not be the pinnacle of automotive beauty, but it at least looks like the person who designed it understood what that is. The front end has gotten the most radical treatment, with chrome eyebrows torn right from David Bowie's face and a big butch grill from the Avalon. The result is a face that looks eerily like the Muppets that advertise it, U2026, but I still like it. Like Animal, it is aggressive but too cute to take seriously. Even with the Muppet boy good looks, the Highlander's best angle is dead side on. With its big rims and swept back stance, the Highlander borrows the best parts of Porsche and Jeep's SUV design. It may not win a design award, but tired parents walking out to their Highlander in the morning will at least be reminded they have a soul. You step into the Highlander.